Okay, great, great. Yeah, so I guess these are the joys of living in the virtual world. Great. So from our perspective, e-government. Yes, but I'm speaking and you're not getting me.
We can hear you.
So what I was going to say is that for e-government, a key component of e-government relates to how government communicates with the citizens. Government, whichever government department it is, has an important role to play, especially in ensuring that their citizens are well protected, are informed, and feel taken care of. So people expect to hear from their governments. They expect to get the information. They expect to know that their governments care about them. And the good thing about Facebook as a multinational company is that we've developed tools that enable governments to communicate effectively with their citizens. So over so many countries, we have several countries leveraging these tools to have effective communications with their citizens. We have empowered governments to connect with communities that previously did not have any engagement with government, raise awareness about important issues, encourage healthy behaviors in their communities, even encourage people to register for services or for their civic duty. Like for instance, the Nigerian government could leverage some of these tech platforms that have been developed by multinationals to encourage people to register for the upcoming elections. So these are some of the ways that people are, or governments are leveraging our tools to really provide effective e-government services. When a citizen feels empowered, when a citizen feels closer to his government, where if they have an issue, they have a channel, a very easy channel to use to relay those issues and get almost immediate feedback in real time, that citizen feels empowered, that citizen feels that the government really looks after them and they will continue to invest and partner with the government to ensure that the country moves forward. So these are some of the trends that we're observing. COVID-19 is a good example where we saw governments across the world leverage the Facebook platform, WhatsApp chatbots to ensure that their citizens were empowered about COVID, had the information to stay safe, and even run vaccination campaigns and information updates on the status of COVID in different geographies. So that's just the additional context I wanted to share based off the experiences we've seen over the past 18 months, where more and more governments across the world, including in Africa, are leveraging some of these digital tools that to ensure that they communicate effectively with their citizens and help deliver proper e-government services. So I'll stop there. I know it's been a messy contribution due to the connectivity issues, but hopefully you get the gist of the point I was trying to make. Thank you.